For more information regarding the civil engineering concepts, please follow my website civilbasics123.com. So go to Google and type civilbasics123. So click on Google search option. So here my website link will be open here. So click on my website link civilbasics123.com. So my complete website will be loaded here like this. It will be consisting of detailed concepts regarding the civil engineering concepts. So I will post at least one article per 2 days. So you can select any one of the article for complete details about this respected civil engineering concepts. Okay, so please follow my website civilbasics123.com. In this video lecture, I will explain you design of RCC footing as per IS 456-2000 code. So in my previous videos, I was explained how to design this respected column section as per the IS 456-2000 code. So I will provide you that respected video link on above code link. You can watch that respected complete concept of complete column design by using IS 456-2000 code here. Okay. So now I will explain you what are the different types of the parameters we need to consider before designing of RCC footing, and what are the steps we have to consider in RCC foundation design, and how to design RCC foundation as per IS 456 code. Okay. So initially, before proceeding to the respected step, so initially we need to consider this 6 number of the steps for RCC foundation design. Okay. So in that, first one is related to the load calculations. Okay. And the second one is related to the size of footing. And third one is related to the calculation of net upward pressure at ultimate load. And fourth one is related to the check for one way slab shear to determine the depth. And the fifth one is related to the check for punching shear, two way shear. Okay. And last one is related to the reinforcement design. Okay. So let us consider these are the 6 number of the steps we need to adopt in foundation design. So now I will explain you what are the different types of the formulas we need to consider in RCC foundation design. Okay. So these are the basic formulas, which is consisting of approximately 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 number of the formulas. Okay. So in that, first one is area of footing, which is equals to total load divided by soil bearing capacity SBC. Okay. And the second one is related to the soil pressure QU, which is equals to total load divided by area provided. And the third one is related to the factored shear force VU1, which is equals to QU into B divided by 2 into B minus C1 minus 2D. Okay. And the next one is one way shear resistance, which is VC1, which is equals to tau C into B into D. And the next one is factored shear force for two way shear. Okay. VU2, which is equals to QU into B square minus C1 plus D square. Okay. And next one is punching two way shear resistance VUC2, which is equals to KS into tau C into B0 into D. And the next one is related to the ultimate moment MU calculation, which is equals to QU into B divided by 8 into B minus C square. Okay. And last one is related to the calculation of AST, which is equals to MU equals to 0.87 times of sigma y AST into D into 1 minus AST into sigma y divided by B into D into sigma CK. Okay. Now I will explain you how to calculate the isolated footing design as per IS 456-2000 code. Okay. So this is the problem definition, which is related to the isolated footing. So design of RCC footing for 400 cross 400 column size with 1200 kilonewton load and take soil bearing capacities 200 kilonewton per meter square and M20 grade concrete and Fe415 grade steel. Okay. So in my previous video, I was already explained how to calculate this respected column dimensions as per the column design section. Okay. So the first step in your calculation part is related to the load calculation section. Okay. So here it was mentioned here, load calculation section. So here they are given the load is approximately equal to 1200 kilonewton. So we need to convert that respective load to factor load or ultimate load. Okay. Which is equals to 1.5 times of P. So 1.5 times of 1200 kilonewton, which is equals to 1800 kilonewton value. Okay. So we need to consider the self weight of the footing and backfill also for designing of isolated footing. So for self weight of footing and backfill, we will consider as 10% of the load on the column. Okay. So here the column load will be considered as 1200 kilonewton. So 0.1 times of 1200, which is comes under the value is 120 mm here. Okay. So total load on the respected footing will be approximately equal to 1800, which is calculated as per the factor load, plus 120, which is related to the self weight of the backfill. Okay. Which is comes under the total value of 1920 kilonewton value. So this is the first step in isolated footing design. Okay. So the second step is related to the calculation of the size of the footing as per the consideration. Okay. So here I will show you the second step. So this is the second step, which is related to the size of the footing. So here the total load as per the calculation we are obtained as 1920 kilonewton in previous step number one. So by assuming square footing, with area of B into B, which is equals to B square. So area of the footing is given in the formula section. So which I was already explained the formula section, which is equals to total load divided by soil bearing capacity. Okay. So the total load will be consisting of 1920 kilonewton divided by soil bearing capacity is 200 here. So we can get the value is 9.6 meter square. By square root of by squaring this respected value of 9.6 meter, we can get the values 3.1 meter for each side. So 3.1 multiplied by 3.1, which can get as the area of the footing, final area of the footing, which is provided for the 1200 kilonewton load, which is approximately equal to 9.61 meter square. Okay, so this is the final area we need to consider for footing section as per the IS-456-2000 code, which is of 1200 kilonewton load. Okay, so this is the second step in calculation part. Now I will explain you the third step, which is related to the calculation of uplift pressure, okay, upward pressure for ultimate load. So here we are already calculated the ultimate load, which is equals to 1920 kilonewton. So if you take that respective load, so again we have to calculate the soil pressure formula, which is equals to Qu, which is equals to total load divided by area provided. So from this calculation we can substitute the value. Total load is approximately 1920 divided by 9.61 is the area of the footing we are providing. So which is comes under the value is approximately Qu equals to 199.80 kilonewton per meter square intensity. So take approximately of 200 kilonewton per meter square. So if you convert that respected value to newton per mm square, so that it can get as 0.2 newton per mm square. Okay. So this is the general diagram which is related to the isolated footing, which is having the reinforcement bars, and this is the uplift pressure Qu. Okay. So Qu value is given as per the calculation is 0.2 newton per mm square here. Okay. So this is the third step in isolated footing design. So now I will explain you the fourth step, which is equals to check for the one way shear and determination of the depth. Okay. So for checking the one way shear and determination of the depth, this diagram is very much important. Okay. So here let us consider this is the column is there and this is the footing. As per the calculation, we are obtained as 3.1 meter cross 3.1 meter dimensions. So we have to take the two sections for the respected foundation. This is a section one and this is a section two. So first section is related to the section of movement. Again, second section is related to the section of shear. Okay. So factor shear force, we are already taking the formula in formula section, which is related to the Qu into B divided by 2 into B minus C1 minus 2D. So the same formula we have to substitute here. So by substituting the values, which is related to the Vu1 equals to 0.2, which is of Qu, we are already calculated. So multiplied by 3100 divided by 2 into 3100 minus C1 is the column dimensions. 400 minus 2 times of D. So by solving we can get the expression which is related to the Vu1 equals to 310 into 2700 minus 2 times of D. So this is the expression one we have to keep in mind. So again as per the calculation we have to take the one more expression by assuming the steel percentage in footing. So as per the clause which is provided in the table number 19 of IS-456-2000 code, so we need to consider the percentage of the steel in footing is approximately PT equals to 0.25%. So which is taken from table number 19 of IS-456-2000 code. Okay. So from this we can get the value which is related to the design shear. Okay. Tau C, which is equals to 0.36 newton per mm square. Okay. So and one way shear resistance value, we have already have the formula which is related to the one way resistance formula, which is equals to VC1 equals to tau C into B into D. So we know that B value as well as the D value, and we know the tau value as per the IS-456 code. So if you substitute the value, then it is getting the value of VC1 equals to 1116D. Okay, so this is the expression 2. From the expression 1, we have the equation which is related to the one, which is a VU1 shear, this is, and this is also shear. So by solving this respected one equation as well as two equation, 310 into 2700 minus 2D equals to 1116D. By solving this respected equation, we can get the value as 482.19 mm as the depth of the footing. Okay. So by taking the cover as 68 mm, let us assume. So by taking this, overall depth of the foundation will be approximately equal to 68 plus this respected 482, which is equals to 550 mm. So this is the complete depth of the foundation, which is taken for the respected 1200 kilonewton column load and 1800 kilonewton factor load. Okay. So this is a general diagram which is related to the foundation depth, which is consisting of approximately 550 mm depth, and these are the reinforcement bars. Okay, so this is the our fourth step in calculation section. Now the next step in calculation of the isolated footing is check for punching shear and two-way shear slab section. Okay, so this is the important step in calculation part. Why? Because we are already calculated the depth of the respected intensity, but we have to check that whether the punching shear and two-way shear is having acceptable limits or not. Okay, so for that we need to consider the formula here, which is equals to VU2 equals to QU into B square minus C1 plus D square. Okay, so let us consider this is the diagram. So this is the column section. So this is the D2 and this is the D1. So we know that as per the section conversion, this is the section of shear which is related to the one-way shear, and this is the center section is related to the section for two-way shear, and this is the section which is related to the moment. So I was explained the complete sections in the previous step. You can watch that. Okay. So by substituting the values here, so VU2 equals to 0.2 times of 3100 square minus 400 plus 550 whole square. So which is comes under the values 1741 kilonewton value here. So this is the first factor we need to consider as VU2. Okay. Again, punching shear for V2, shear resistance, we have one more formula is there, which is related to the Ks into tau C into B naught into D. Okay. So from this formula, we can easily calculate shear VC2. So here the value of B naught is unknown. Okay. So we need to calculate that respected value as per the IS code. So as per the IS code, it is having B naught equals to 4 times of C1 plus D. So by substituting the values, 4 into 400 plus 550, which is comes under the values 3800 mm here. Okay. So again, we have to calculate the value which is related to the tau C. So as per the class 31.6.3, the permissible stress value which is there here, okay, as per the IS 456-2000 code, tau C equals to 0.25 times of sigma CK and KS equals to 1 here. Okay, so tau C equals to 0.25 times of square root of 20. Why? Because we are already know that compressed strength of the concrete is considered as 20. Okay, so by substituting the value, we can get the values 1.118 newton per mm square. Okay, so two-way shear should be equals to, by substituting the total value in this formula, we can get 1 into 1.118 into 3800 into 550, which is equals to 2336.62 kilonewton here. So here VC2 is greater than VU2. Okay. So hence factor of shear force is greater than punching shear. So hence it is safe to provide the 550 mm depth. So this is an important step in calculation of isolated footing design. So this is the fifth step under consideration. So from the calculation part, we are obtained that punching shear is less than factor shear. So hence it is safe. Okay. The last step, now we have to calculate the reinforcement value. That is the last step in our design calculation. So this is the last step in this respected calculation part, which is consisting of the reinforcement values. So we need to take the formula which is related to the ultimate moment. So from the formula section, we have the ultimate moment value, which is equals to QU into B divided by 8 into B minus C square. Okay. So basically this respected formula was derived from WL square 8 section. Okay. So by substituting the value, we can get here as 0.2 into 3100 divided by 8 into 3100 minus 400 whole square. So that we can get the value of intensity as 564.975 kilonewton meter. So this is the bending moment value which is required for designing of the area of the steel. Okay. So we have one more formula is there, which is equals to beam calculation of the reinforcement section. ME equals to 0.87 times of sigma y into AST into D into 1 minus AST into sigma y divided by B into D into sigma CK. Okay. So we have this formula. So by substituting the value, so this is the moment value we are obtained from this respected calculation, 564.975 into 10 power 6, which is equals to 0.87 into 415 into AST into 550 into 1 minus AST into 415 divided by 3100 into 550 into 20. So that we can get the value of AST is approximately equal to 2951.4 mm square. So by providing, let us consider, just I am taking 16 mm diameter bar. By providing 16 mm diameter bar, so initially we need to calculate the area of the one bar. So area of the one bar equals to pi by 4 times of 16 square, which is approximately equal to 201 mm square here. Okay. So from this calculation, we can easily calculate number of the bars that is required for this respective reinforcement section. So for that, we need to take the factor AST by area of one bar. Okay. So as per the calculation, we are obtained that AST is 2951.4
divided by area of the 1 bar is 201, which is approximately equal to 14.68. So 14.68 is not a number. So we need to convert that expected value to that number. So by taking 15 numbers of 16 mm diameter, inset is okay. So for the respected 15 numbers of 16 mm diameter, so we need to calculate the spacing. So spacing is given by A divided by AST, area of the 1 bar divided by AST into width of the footing. So here we have the formula here, okay. By substituting the values, 201 divided by 2951.4 into 3100, so that it can get the distance is 211.12 mm, okay. So hence take 210 mm center to center distance for the each bar. So this is the center to center distance between the each bar spacing option. So the final reinforcement value, which is related to the 16 mm diameter bars, we have to take at 210 center to center distance for both x direction and y direction for the mesh, which is related to the 3.1 meter cross 3.1 meter foundation section. Okay, so this is the final reinforcement value as per the load consideration. Okay, so this is the final diagram which is related to the isolated footing reinforcement section. It is consisting of 16 mm diameter at 210 center to center distance between the each bar for the respected mesh. Okay, so this is the depth of the foundation and this is the column reinforcement. We are already calculated the respected column reinforcement in my previous videos, so you can watch that, which is consisting of approximately 8 numbers of 16 mm diameter bar. Okay, so this is the complete concept which is related to the reinforcement calculation of isolated footing as per the manual method. So it will be consisting of approximately of 6 numbers of the steps. One is related to the load calculation and second one is related to the size of the footing. Third one is related to the calculation of net upward pressure at ultimate load. And fourth one is check for one way shear, and fifth one is check for punching shear and two way shear. And last one is reinforcement values. Okay. So I will update the same concept in my website civilbasics123.com tomorrow. So you can watch the complete calculation there. Okay. So if you have any queries about this respected video, please try to text me your questions in the below comment box. I will try to give the answer for the respected questions. Thank you.